Thank you, God, for giving me the tools to bring to light. Thank you, God, for giving me insight. Thank you, God, for my freedom and my limitless potential. If you agree, you can say amen.
Amen.
Thank you, God, for bringing me your divine abundance with great ease. Thank you, God, for garmenting me in joy and spirit.
Amen.
Thank you, God, for showing me that all power comes from stillness. Thank you, God, for making and fulfilling my needs. They are my great teachers. Thank you, God, for creating all of your people as sacred vessels. Thank you, God, for making harmony and balance my true nature. Thank you, God, for making my body just a vehicle. I'm so much more. I'm more than my body and my emotional reactions. Thank you, God, for not making me a slave to my patterns. Thank you, God, for placing me in this moment in safety and perfection.
Amen.
Thank you, God, for freeing me from illusion, from awakening me. Thank you, God, for awakening me to this moment and for allowing me to touch the changeless you. Together we say. Thank you, God, for removing illusion from my eyes, for awakening me to this moment, and for allowing me to touch the changeless you. So, Diane, what jumps out from this particular tefillah, from this one component in a 15-part prayer, is the idea that we change, we grow, we evolve, and God is patient. It's on these high and holy days that we say, no self-esse of him. God can wait for a thousand lifetimes for us to get the idea of God right. Every year we talk about the words of Esther Hicks, you know, she said something that will forever change me as a theologian. She said, you are that which you call God. If you think about it, what do we call God? We call God Morid HaGeshem, right? The one who makes it rain. They're spending $13 trillion in Australia to figure out how to make it rain. They're getting close. They're trying to make it rain over here, and it rains over there, but they're getting close. And we say, Tchias HaMeisim, the one who brings back the dead. Well, hey, I've got two words for you. Maybe one. Defibrillation. I mean, We're learning how to do what we attribute to God. Now, is that blasphemy? Possibly. It may have been 200 years ago. But today it certainly is not. And so what thrills me, I'm so glad you asked this question. What thrills me is not what I call God today, but what my daughter and her children will call God tomorrow. Because God is always the unknown. God is always the untamable, the unfathomable. And what's beautiful is that all of that will change. But my idea here, my input, if you would, is that